In this lesson, we're going to cover keyword density. Let's start by understanding what that is. Put simply, keyword density is a measurement of the number of times a keyword appears on your page. It's presented as a ratio or a percentage of the overall word count. Keyword density is foundational to SEO. It can affect whether your pages rank high or not at all. And here's why. As well as your meta title and description, keyword density is a way for Google to understand the keywords that your page is optimizing for. Let me explain this with an oversimplified example. If your page mentions the benefits of oranges a couple of times, there's a good chance that your page, or at least some of it, is about the benefits of oranges. But therein lies the challenge. On the one hand, it's important to make sure that your keyword density is sufficient for a targeted keyword. In other words, you should mention that keyword enough times. But on the other hand, if you overdo it, the search engine can penalize you for over-optimizing, which is a nice way of saying keyword stuffing. So your next question should be, well, what keyword density should I aim for? Well, that's a tricky thing. You see, there is no magic number. What's more, it's likely to vary for different scenarios. In the next section, we'll cover how to work out the ideal keyword density for a given situation. But it's important not to obsess over these numbers, and remember, you're creating content primarily for humans and not machines. So let's take a look at how to calculate keyword density. To figure out the keyword density in a piece of content, divide the number of times a keyword appears in the text by number of words in the article. For example, 10 divided by 1000 equals 0.001. Then multiply by 100 to get a percentage. In this example, the keyword density would be 1%. With regards to the ideal keyword density, the general advice is to aim for 1%. That means mentioning your target keyword once or twice every 100 words. But remember to keep the flow of your text natural. Don't keep repeating the target keyword if it doesn't make sense to do so. Don't be the online equivalent of that guy who keeps mentioning your name at every sentence. It's just weird. And remember this, following some keyword density rule is not mandatory if you're focused on targeting topics rather than keywords, like we covered in the keyword clustering lesson. Producing good and relevant content should always be your priority. But if you do want to observe keyword density in your articles, here's how to keep it natural. And you may want to bookmark this section. 1. Increase the word count. Creating longer content is the most common and effective way to make the keyword density more natural. The alternative is a short article with too many keywords, which of course you should avoid. Also remember that long-form content provides more information, which is good for the reader and can help you rank for more keywords. 2. Focus on informational content. Producing more content to serve the informational search intent would help your keyword density be more natural because of the long-tail keywords. Remember that long-tail keywords are most useful in informational articles, whereas short-tail keywords mostly appear in transactional search intents. 3. Remember that quality always comes first. Generally, keyword density is not as important as content quality, so always consider whether adding more keywords would reduce the quality of your content. A higher keyword density only looks natural when the quality of the content is good and it reads naturally. In the next lesson, we'll be looking at how to structure page content with headings. I'll see you there.